Hello, everybody. Gbenga, Olatunjiye. I hope we are doing great. And by popular demand, we'll be going into performance management series beginning from today. And this is a course, actually, that is tailored towards developing our capacity to be able to provide decision-making information and decision-making support to management of any organization in any nation as chartered accountants. So we will be introducing ourselves to strategic management. Don't forget, we'll be treating strategy and corporate governance, so you could look up those videos. So this is going to help in knowing much more better and having a solid foundation when it comes to performance management, because performance management has some branches that are interlinked to it, like strategic financial management, management information, corporate strategic management and ethics, business management and finance. All these relate directly to performance management. So you could look up on those videos that we've done. So we'll be introducing ourselves also to strategic planning and control. We'll be introducing ourselves to strategic objectives and levels of management. So let us go into what we'll be looking at in details. So we'll be looking at under strategic planning and control, the definition of strategic planning and control. Because when we are talking about performance management, we cannot but talk about strategy, cannot but talk about planning, cannot but talk about control. So all these, what are their definitions? So we will introduce ourselves to their definition, laying the foundation in this video. Then we will talk about management accounting and purposes of management accounting. Strategic and performance management is a decision-making support system. It dwells on information, and management accounting provides such information. So we'll be introducing ourselves to the purposes of accounting management. Management accounting, rather, in form of planning purposes, its usefulness in control and its usefulness in decision making. So also we will look at the levels of strategic planning. Levels of strategic planning will be looked at, and also we will move on to strategic planning processes, the process involved in taking decision and in planning. Then we'll move on to strategic objectives. And it is important for us to know that this, of course, all of them are important, but this strategic objective is key and the apex decision making, like the board of directors and the like. Also, we dealt with it under CSME. Please look up the videos. Most anchor when it comes to strategic objective. So we'll be introducing ourselves and deal with planning and corporate objectives. Every organization must have corporate objectives, which must be set by either the shareholders, the people that envision the organization in coming to reality, or the board. So the apex decision makers must anchor and decide on strategic objective. Then it spiral down to the management and the board, the directors and the like. We'll talk about the need for performance measurements. the need for performance measurements. How are we going to measure our objectives? How will our objectives become KPI, key performance indicator, and the like? How are we going to ensure that we turn around our key performance indicators to success? How are we going to ensure that we turn around our critical success factor into becoming key performance indicator? So we'll be looking at the need for performance measurement and things that relate to it. Management accounting and performance measurement. We'll be looking at two. Management accounting, performance measurement will be looked at. Then we are going to deal with the performance management levels. What are the levels involved? So when we are talking about levels of management, so we'll be looking at the tactical, the strategic, we'll be looking at the operational aspects of management level. Also, in performance management, in corporate organization, and when decisions are being made, there will always be conflicts of interest. There will always be conflict between the strategic plan and the short-term plan. There will always be conflict between directors' personal interest and personal goal and the corporate objectives. So we'll be looking at potential conflicts between strategic planning and short-term planning. The potential conflicts between strategic planning and short-term planning. And of course, we are going to look at the resolution of these two. So after this, we'll be talking about the overview of cost planning and control. The overview of cost planning and control will be looked at, and we'll be studying the performance management information, the sources of information, the high and low method, linear regression analysis, marginal costing and absorption costing will be looked at, ABC will be looked at, that is activity-based costing. Then we'll talk about the ethics that surrounds performance management as organization. So this is by way of introducing ourselves to performance management. If you are just joining us on GJM's Associate platform, we highly recognize you. You are welcome. You are important to us, and you've been part of us. We highly recognize you, and we I'd love that you subscribe. It's a free subscription to this community. Let us build it together. So when you subscribe, you put yourself in position to receive timely information that will release new videos and tutorial. And also, people around you can be beneficial and be easily reached. Also, when you do that, you encourage us. I want to believe you are going to encourage us, because this community is building other lives, and we are making a nation great, the world better. So please give us thumb up, subscribe to us, like us, comment, engage us. GJM's Associates, we are value to life, we are value to your businesses.